Hi dear students, today I am going to tell you about the chapter Potentials and Capacitance. Are you ready? See, the chapter is about the term potential. I will tell you something about potential. Are you ready? Potential is actually a simple term which gives the direction of flow of positive charges. Simply, positive charges flow from high potential to low potential. For example, we are having a charge plus Q over here and two points are marked over here, A and B. So, I am asking you at which point the potential is high, at A or B. Or VA is the potential at this point and VB is the potential at that point. Then can you tell me which point is having greater potential? So simple. You place a positive charge over here and observe the motion. When we are placing a positive charge over here, due to repulsion, the positive charge will move from A to B. So, we can say that the potential at A is greater than potential at B. So, as we move away from the positive charge, the potential decreases and at infinity the potential becomes zero. Ready? This is the basic idea about the term potential.
In physics, the term potential at a point is defined as the work done in moving unit positive charge from infinity to that point. Then what is the potential at A? It is the work done in moving unit positive charge from infinity to A. Then what is the potential at B? It is the work done in moving unit positive charge from infinity to B. Ready? Then what is the work done in moving unit positive charge from B to A? In the opposite direction of electric field intensity, see the direction of electric field intensity is from positive outward and we are moving unit positive charge from B to A in the opposite direction of electric field intensity. The work done in moving unit positive charge from B to A is called the potential difference between A and B. So, here A is at a greater potential, then VA minus VB is the potential difference between these two terms. Potential difference is very important. While studying current electricity, we studied that the charge is flowing from high potential to low potential, or the direction of current is from high potential to low potential. Okay, so let me tell you once again. We are having a charge plus Q over here and the work done in moving unit positive charge from infinity to A is called potential at A and the work done in moving unit positive charge from infinity to B is called potential at B and the work done in moving unit positive charge from B to A is the potential difference between A and B. Ready? So potential difference we can write it as V equal to VA minus V. Now we are going to derive the potential near a point charge. It is so simple. See, consider a point charge Q. And what is the electric field intensity at a distance x from the charge Q? It is E equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by x square. And you know, this is the basic equation for electric field intensity. And it is inverse square. See, here x is the distance. Now the thing is, our plan is to find the potential at a distance r from this charge, say this one. Then the basic definition for potential at a point P is, it is the work done in moving unit positive charge from infinity to that point. So we are going to find the total work done in moving unit positive charge from infinity to P. For that, we are familiar with the basic equation for work. Work is equal to force into displacement. In mechanics, we derived the potential energy by multiplying force and displacement. See, upward force required is mg and height is h. Mg into h is mgh. The same way, we are going to find the work done in moving unit positive charge from infinity to the point P. But here there is a problem. The problem is the force over unit positive charge depends on distance from charge Q. So when you are moving away from the charge, the force decreases and at infinity the force is zero. So this is actually a case of variable force problem. So we cannot do that simply by using W equal to F inverse. So for that we are having an idea. You place the positive charge over here and move a little, say dx. Then what is the work done in moving that through a small distance dW equal to F into dx. Then how can we find the total work? By integrating this equation. Ready? And what is the force required? The force over plus 1 coulomb is outward and it is written over here, E equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by x square. So we have to apply the same force in the opposite direction. So instead of F, let us substitute minus. Then this equation will be minus integral. Now substitute the value for E here, minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by x square into dx. And we are going to find the work done from infinity to R. So we are integrating this from infinity to R. So take all in common. Raised to minus 2 dx. How can we integrate this? Simple, minus q by 4 pi epsilon 0 into the integral of x raised to minus 2 is minus 1 by x from infinity to R. So this will be minus q by 4 pi epsilon 0 into minus 1 by r minus 1 by infinity. 1 by infinity is 0, so minus and will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r. This work will be stored as the potential. So we can write potential V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r. Don't forget this equation, V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by r. So how we derived this equation? First we took a positive charge and we moved it through a small distance dx. Then what is the work done in moving unit positive charge through a small distance dx? dW equal to F dx. But normally you know that if the force is variable, the work done can be found using the equation work is equal to integral F dx. Instead of F, substitute the value minus E, then substituting E over here, then integrating 1 by x square. Integral is minus 1 by x and applying limit from infinity to R, then you will get this, and that work is same as that of the potential. So potential at a point P at a distance R from a charge Q is V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R. Now let us think about the superposition principle. Superposition principle for potential is so simple. If you want to find the potential at a point, then you consider the potential due to all the individual charges. See, Q1, Q2, Q3 all are here. All are at a distance marked R1, R2 and R3. Then how can you find the total potential at a P? We are having the basic equation for potential V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q by R. So what is the potential at a distance R1 from a charge Q1? Then we can write V1 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 by R1. What is the potential at P due to Q2? V2 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 Q2 by R2. Similarly due to Q3. So according to superposition principle, the total potential at P is V equal to V1 plus V2 plus etc. So substituting the values, we will get 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 into Q1 by R1 plus Q2 by R2 plus etc. So repeat, in the case of potential, we can find the total potential at a point P by taking the sum. And now we will remind one point. The potential near a positive charge is positive and the potential near a negative charge is negative. So while considering negative charges, you must substitute the sign. Ready? So this is the superposition principle for potential. But in electrostatics, this is not the case. The total electric field intensity is the vector sum of electric field due to individual charge. But in the case of potential, it is the sum of potential due to individual charge. Now let us derive the potential near a dipole. Consider a dipole at a having length 2a, so half of this length is a, this is a. Our plan is to find the potential at a point P. For that, let us mark this. So we are going to find the potential at a point at a distance r from the center of an electric dipole. For that, let us mark all these. Let this distance say r1, this distance say r2. Then how can we find the potential at P? By using superposition principle. What is superposition principle? The total potential at P is the sum of potential due to this plus q and the minus q. First let us write the potential due to plus q. Say V1 is equal to, we know the equation, 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 q by c. Now the distance is actually r1. The same way we can write the potential due to minus q. Potential due to minus q is V2 equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 c minus q. So don't forget to write the divided by R2. Then how can we find the total potential? Simply adding these two. Now substitute the values. We can take q by 4 pi epsilon 0 in common. So it will be 1 by R1 minus 1 by R. Now our plan is to find R1 and R. See, R1 is the distance from plus q to p. For that we are having a plan. Draw a perpendicular over here. And this distance, you know, the distance between the dipole is actually 2a. Now, take this angle as theta. Then this side is a, this angle is theta. Then this will be a cos theta. Now our plan is to substitute the value for R1 and R2. For that, let us mark a right triangle over here and this angle say theta. Then for finding the distance AP, it is almost equal to BP. For finding BP, it is actually CP minus A cos theta. Actually CP we know R. So for finding R1, we have to find this distance BP. BP is actually R minus A cos theta. So instead of R1, let us substitute R minus A cos theta. And the same way, we can draw a perpendicular here. Then this distance will also be A cos theta. Then instead of PD, we can find the distance PF. PF is actually PC plus CF. PC we are familiar, it is a small letter. So instead of finding PD, we can find R plus A cos theta. So this term will be R plus A cos theta. Now for finding the total potential, we have to solve this. Then we will get into R plus A cos theta minus R minus A plus by C. A minus B into A plus B. A square minus B. Now open the bracket, we will get transparent. Now finally the equation will be Q by 4 pi epsilon 0 into 2A cos theta by C. Since A is very small, A square cos square theta can be neglect. So denominator will be awesome. So this is actually the potential at a distance P from a dipole. This can be written as, see, we are familiar with the term dipole moment. Dipole moment is the product of any one of the charge into distance separation. Here the distance separation is 2a, so 2a into q is actually, substituting the value for p here, we will get the potential V equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 p cos theta by r. This is the potential near a time. Ready? For finding the axial and equatorial line, see, for equatorial line, the angle over here is actually 90 degree. So for equatorial line, V is equal to, see, 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 cos 90. So it is 0 here. But for an axial point, the value of theta is actually 0. So for axial line, the potential will be V is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P by R square. Don't forget this derivation. So for equatorial point, the potential is 0. And for the axial point, the potential is 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 P by R square.